Hello everyone, I'll be talking on cleaning and disposal in COVID ward. How frequently the cleaning of surfaces should be done? It can be roughly divided into two parts, like heated surfaces and loaded surfaces. Heated surfaces are those surfaces where each individual patient or person who is present in isolation ward will be going to touch and use that material and things like light switches, telephone, doorknobs, etc. And the loaded surfaces are those where the use or the touching will be at lesser amount. Again, there will be two areas, clinical areas and non-clinical areas. Clinical areas are those where the confirmed or suspected COVID-19 case will be kept. And non-clinical areas include the nurse's station where the patient activity won't be present. So cleaning in high-touch surfaces, clinical areas will be 1 to 2 hourly, and where the patient is not kept 2 to 3 hourly, and non-clinical areas for 3 to 4 hourly. While cleaning in loaded surfaces areas for clinical areas is 2 to 3 hourly for where the patient has been kept, and 3 to 4 hourly where the patient is not present and rest of the thing can be cleaned once per a shift. What are the clinical guidelines? In nutshell, first, the area to be cleaned has to be sealed. No one can be allowed apart from the cleaning personnel. Cleaning staff should wear personal protective equipment. The sequence or the start of the cleaning should include the mopping of the floor, then wipe down all the surfaces. Linen should be given to hot water laundry cycles. It includes the chadar, bed sheets, curtains and rest of the cloth material. Whatever things has been used for cleaning, that should be discarded, like mop head or any other cloth which has been used for wiping out. The buckets has been disinfected by soaking in 1% sodium hypochlorite solution or rinsing in hot water. So in detail, floor should be cleaned in 3 bucket systems. First will be the plain water one, another will be with detergent solution, and third bucket with 1% sodium hypochlorite, which has to be prepared freshly. First, mop the area with warm water and detergent solution. After mopping, clean the mop in plain water and squeeze it. Mop area again using sodium hypochlorite after drying the area. Ceiling and walls should be done clean with damp dusting by using 1% sodium hypochlorite. Door and doorknobs can be cleaned with detergent or 1% sodium hypochlorite solution. Laboratories where spill is occurred, then spill management protocol should be followed, and the cleaning should include 1% sodium hypochlorite. Stethoscope, BP apparatus and thermometers that has to be cleaned after each use by wiping down with alcohol based disinfectant. Injection or dressing trolley should be cleaned daily with detergent and water after each use. Refrigerator should be cleaned once in a week. First, have to empty the refrigerator, defrost it, decontaminate it, clean with detergent and then dry it properly, put on the things which has been removed. Rest of the equipment, whenever possible, portable radiographic equipment should be used to limit transportation of patients. All areas and surfaces of equipment should be cleaned with 1% sodium hypochlorite. Sensitive probes of equipment can be wiped with 70% alcohol. And CTMR machines can be cleaned as per manufacturer's instruction. So general cleaning, first scrub the floor, clean with plain water, allow it to dry, and then mop with 1% hypochlorite solution. Lockers, tables, cupboards, wardrobes, benches, shelves can be cleaned with detergent and water. Railings has to be cleaned by following 3 bucket systems. Mirror, glass, stainless steel or any other sink, furniture, telephone, chair, light switches, curtains that can be cleaned with detergent and water. Coming to cleaning of toilets, toilet pot and floor can be cleaned with 1% sodium hypochlorite solution, and the rest of the areas in the toilet can be cleaned with detergent and water. Coming to the disposal part, disposal of personal protective equipment, liquids based, solid based. How to do it? PPEs used and other contaminated waste generated from patients or by COVID-19 waste handlers shall be stored separately in yellow bag at separate biomedical waste storage point and shall be pre-treated with autoclaving before transfer to temporary storage area. and then hand over to common treatment facility in yellow colored bags with specific marking as COVID-19 waste. Liquid waste generated during diagnosis shall be pre-treated in autoclave and then handed over to common treatment facility in spill-proof containers, in double-layered yellow-colored bags with specific marking as COVID-19 waste and biohazard symbol. CTF operator may deny accepting improperly packed or damaged containers of COVID-19 waste. Now, this is the guideline given by NRHM. We will be following this guideline for our hospital. So, in yellow bags, there will be cap, mask, gown, personal protective equipment, dressing, plaster cast, cotton balls. In red bag, recyclable or disposable things like syringe, IV sets, gloves, Ryle's tube, Eurosac bag and plastic material. In white, transparent container, sharp metal, metallic things, needles, blade, scalpels. In blue colored, cardboard boxes, broken glasses, empty ampules and metallic things can be put. Now, regarding the transportation of biomedical waste, according to above classification, the yellow colored double layered bags can be allowed to fill only 3/4, that is 75%. There should be one place which is dedicated to store that area till Surya treatment facility, that is the common treatment facility for our hospital, will come to take. The person who is transporting that bags, fulfilled bags to Surya treatment facility should use the trolley which is completely dedicated to that ward, and after the use of that trolley, that should be cleaned with 1% sodium hypochlorite solution. All the people who are transporting these waste material from the isolation ward towards the CTF, that is Surya Central Treatment Facility, should use heavy duty gumboot, clothes, cap mask, plastic apron, that is the all personal protective equipment material. COVID-19, the whole Central Treatment Facility has been given to Surya Central Treatment Facility MIDC Miraj. So there will be the separate vehicle for just transporting this COVID-19 waste. While driving, that vehicle should include personal protective equipment and spill management kit. So for this whole things, references used are Maharashtra Pollution Control Board, National Rural Health Mission and GMC Miraj guidelines for cleaning and disposal. Thank you.